Transportation Secretary Jun Abaya says the government is close to taking over MRT3 and extending LRT1. Lois Calderon reports.
Just 2 months since he took over as transport chief, Jun Abaya says the government's plans to upgrade MRT3 and LRT1 are on track. Abaya says the talks to buy out Manuel Pangilinan's Metro Pacific Group from MRT3 are in advanced stages and that they're just waiting for Malacanang's approval. The government wants to take over MRT3 so it can set the terms of its expansion and bid out the project and the 25-year operating contract.
We will now buy out all private interests and convert everything to government. The decision of a equity buyout of government has proceeded quite well, and I think it's already at the office of the president.
Abaya says the bidding process for LRT1's extension and operation should start by January and awarded by April. LRT Line 1 will be extended from Baclaran all the way to Cavite. Competing for the project are the tandem of Manuel Pangilinan and Ayala Group, the San Miguel Group, DMCI, and a consortium led by Korean company Samsung.
Whoever bids the highest concession fee, whatever they pay government, will be the winner. The maximum that government will take is the measure.
There was good news on roads as well. A Pangilinan executive says the group's Manila Connector Road projects got conditional NEDA approval earlier this month. The condition, the Metro Pacific Group and the San Miguel Group, which plans to build another road connecting the North and South Expressways, agree on the section they will share. Malacanang gave the two groups until December 15 to come to an agreement.
Our intention is to be treated as co-equals. Dapat magtiwalaan, di ba? Na kung kukolekta, suklian. Walang lamangan. Kasi yun ang catchment of the traffic. Eh. So dapat, since it's the most profitable, co-equal.
The two groups have competed for many projects, making them known as frenemies. Agreeing to equal footing may be just what's needed to get their two projects going. Lois Calderon, ABS-CBN News.